Is PageSpeed score an actual ranking factor?
Well, PageSpeed affects your SEO a lot.
So yeah, this data suggests that PageSpeed might not be some sort of SEO magic bullet.
And while a lot of people obsess over improving their site speed by fractions of a second, from an SEO perspective, it doesn't really matter much for most sites.
As you can see, different industry influencers have different points of view on this matter. But let's take a look at what the only reliable source, aka Google, has to say about this. As Google states in its blog, in recent years, search has added a variety of user experience criteria, such as how quickly pages load and mobile friendliness, as factors for ranking results. So yeah, PageSpeed is actually a ranking factor for your clients' WordPress websites. I will be using as much plain speak here as possible, so if any of this starts getting too overwhelming for you, just visit our website where we keep it all plain and simple for agencies. PageSpeed is a cumulative score of 6 factors affecting your website speed. The 3 most important factors combined are called the core web vitals. Let's review each one of them one by one. The first one is largest contentful paint. This metric measures the time it takes for a website to show the user the largest content on the screen, complete and ready for interaction. Imagine you have a video on the homepage of your sales website that directly affects your conversion rate, but it takes too long to load and all the user sees is a blank page. The chances of that user becoming a paying customer just dropped by 3 to 4 times. Next comes first input delay. This metric measures the time from when a user first interacts with your site to the time when the browser is actually able to respond to that interaction. So let's say a user visiting your website tries to open a page from the menu and it takes too long to open because of heavy JavaScript. You can now imagine how frustrated users will be and how unlikely it is that they convert to a paying customer or even just stick around on your website. And the last factor is cumulative layout shift. It measures a website's instability. This measure determines whether a website behaves as the user expects it to behave. For example, if a button moves or shakes, it can negatively affect your page experience. So, the user opens your website, starts exploring your product, and then bam! After one tiny interaction with your website, content jumps from one side to another, disrupting the entire experience. Needless to say, your conversion rate just dropped significantly. As Google states, while the core web vitals are the critical metrics for understanding and delivering a great user experience, there are other vital metrics as well. One of these other vital metrics is time to first byte. It's a foundational metric for measuring connection setup time and web server responsiveness in both the lab and the field. It helps identify when a web server is too slow to respond to requests. In the case of navigation requests, that is, requests for an HTML document, it precedes every other meaningful loading performance metric. Translation, this means that having high performance hosting is crucial for a high PageSpeed score and in order to pass the Core Web Vitals test. If this all sounds too complicated for you, check out 10web. Let our automated PageSpeed booster improve your PageSpeed score and Core Web Vitals. Start for free, no credit card required.